pistol shots ring out in a barroom night. Enter Betty Valentine from the upper hall. She sees a bartender in a pool of blood. Cries out, my God, they killed them all. Here comes the story of the hurricane. The man the authorities came to blame for something that he never done. Put in a prison cell, but one time he could have been the champion of the world. And so Patty calls the cops, and they arrive on the scene with their red lights flashing in a hot New Jersey night. Meanwhile, far away in another part of town, Reuben Carter and a couple of friends are driving around. Number one contender for the middleweight was about to go down when a cop pulled him over to the side of the road, just like the time before and the time before that. In Patterson, that's just the way things go. If you're black, you might as well not show up on the street unless you wanna draw the heat. Him and other Dexter Bradley were just out prowling around. He said, I saw two men running out who looked like middleweights. Jumped into a white car without upstate plates. And Miss Patty Valentine just nodded her head. Cops said, wait a minute, boys, this one's not dead. So they took him to the infirmary. And though this man could hardly see, they told him he could identify the guilty man. Story of the hurricane. The man the authorities came to blame for something that he never done. Put in a prison cell, but one time he could have been the champion of the world. Four months later, the ghetto's on flame. South America fighting for his name. Well, out the decks, the Bradley's still in the robbery game. And the cops are putting the screws to him, looking for somebody to blame. Remember that murder that you happened in a bar? Remember you said you saw the getaway car? Thinking like the playboy with the law. Think it might have been that fighter that you saw running that night. Don't forget that you are white. Dexter Bradley said, I'm really not sure. The cop said, a poor boy like you can use a break. We got you for the motel job, and you're talking to your friend Bello. You don't want to have to go back to jail, be a nice fellow. You'll be doing society a favor. That son of a bitch is brave and getting braver. We want to put his ass in the stir. We want to pin this triple murder on him. He ain't no gentleman. Yeah. Reuben could take a man out with just one punch, but he never did like to talk about it all that much. It's my work, he'd say, I do it for pay. And when it's over,
just as soon go on my way up to some paradise where the trout streams flow and the air is nice, and ride a horse along the trail. But then they took him to the jailhouse where they tried to turn a man. Had a chance. The judge made Reuben's witnesses drunk and smoking slums. To the white folks who watched, he was a revolutionary bum. And to the black folks, he was just a crazy nigger. No one doubted that he pulled the trigger. And though they could not produce the gun, the DA said he was the one who did the deed. And the old Algeria agreed. Carter was falsely tried. The crime was murder one. Guess who testified? Beto and Bradley, and they both all they lied. And the newspapers, they all went along for the ride. How can the life of such a man be in the palm of some fool's hand? To see him obviously framed couldn't help but make me feel ashamed. To live in a land where justice is again. In the coats and the ties, I'm free to drink martinis and watch the sunrise. While Reuben sits like Buddha in a 10-foot cell, an innocent man in a living hell. Yes, that's the story of the hurricane, but it won't be over till they clear his name and give him back the time he's done. Put in a prison cell, but one time he could have been the champion of the world.